Let's start the rear of the tire, rear end. So I use something to measure the height from the ground. Could be anything, but I need it to be the same at the rear, and then on the front of the tire, I need to be the same height. I want it to be the highest possible, so as for the tape to pass under the car without getting bent. So I want the tape to be perfectly horizontal, no curves, and depends if behind the wheel the car is lower, then I will take that measure. If in front of the wheel the car is lower, I will take that measure. So let's see. I usually use a small bolt like this to secure the tape, and that's on the right side, rear of the well. I'll take a reference. Let's say I'll take this board here, the exterior side, and you'll be needing to make sure the tape is straight. You'll be needing to read perhaps in millimeters because it's much more accurate. You want to lecture in front and rear of the well within 2 millimeters, not more. In this case, I have 164 centimeters and 6 millimeters, so 164.6. You better write it down because you're gonna probably forget it in the next few seconds. Of the wells now, right well attaching the tape. Left well, I have 164 in front and 164 centimeters, 0.6 in the rear. So there is toe in. Just showing this is how the geometry of the car works. Let's assume these are the wheels, this is the steering wheel, this is the rear front of the car, so this is the rear and the front of each wheel. Now each wheel is connected to the car by the suspension, and the suspension has bushings, and those bushings or bushes usually when you hit a pothole they will turn a little bit, and the wheel will change its orientation. Now I'm going to exaggerate all movements, but this is how it works. Let's say you hit a pothole with this guy, with this side wheel, and the wheel will remain like this. It's exaggerated, but at a smaller scale, that's what it does. Now the car always wants the wheel to be more parallel possible, the most parallel possible. So what the car will do at that moment, it will turn like this. Have a toe in here, it's shorter here in the bottom. Rear end of the wheel is larger, and the steering will turn to one side. Now, the garage, if you bring the car to the garage, they will want to adjust the tire on the ends. And now, the tire on the ends are always located at the rear end of each side. So, what the garage guy will do, he will take this, open this tire on the end, and will shorten it. So, shorten it like this, and then when you drive the car, look what happens. The car wants the wheel to be parallel again. Your geometry is correct again. And the same goes if the wheel was torn that way, right? So if the wheel is torn that way, the car will drive like that with the steering to the left. Actually, this side. I will extend this tire on the end like this, and then the car will drive straight like that.